Good morning. It's another lovely, it's brilliant sunny morning. It's 9 o'clock at the moment. Sun's already very hot. It's been up for a couple of hours and it's going to be another scorcher today. Temperatures in the mid 30s. Clear blue skies, but beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I just thought I'd have a little look around the what I call the sort of the field garden. It's not actually as big as a field, but it's certainly bigger than a back garden. And it's kind of been the sort of area that needs most work. What my plan is to kind of sort of encourage wildflowers to have a bigger variety of trees, native trees, dotted around for the sort of birds and insect life. And just generally sort of maintain it. And then the grass, obviously there's an awful lot of grass, grows up very tall. To harvest that, which I'm using in the vegetable garden around the raised beds as really deep mulch. I'm just bringing that in by the barrow load. To stop the weeds coming up to sort of protect, you know, keep the moisture in a little bit. And then eventually it'll rot down and become compost, which will then get added to the raised beds, and yeah, kind of be a sort of cycle of doing that each year. So anyway, I thought I'd start on one of the least tamed areas here, just so you can see what the whole thing was like originally when I bought the house 4 years ago, pretty much 4 years ago exactly. I think this area out here probably did have fruit trees. This tallest tree just there, it is a plum tree, but very old. They don't really make any fruits now. And of course around them, where it wasn't maintained for many years, where the plums dropped and all these little saplings spring up, which unfortunately don't actually make nice new plum trees. They kind of revert to the sort of wild ones and either don't have any fruit at all or they just have the really tiny, tiny little fruits on them. So they're not much use to encourage for fruit. So there's just sort of stacks of these everywhere. There's also lots of wild roses that come up everywhere. I think there's one here, there should be one here, which again I want to leave some of them because obviously you've got the rose hips coming on them, which are nice for the birds, and the flowers are lovely as well in spring, but they need to be thinned out an awful lot because I'm fed up of being scratched by them. So there's hawthorns come up. I think they're hawthorns anyway. Look like hawthorn leaves. So there's lots of those spring up as well. Again, we sort of leave few of them for the berries. There's lots of little oaks. It's the Turkish oak, not the English oak. But they still make nice big strong trees. So I'm leaving those to mature as well. But yeah, it's a case of clearing it. So I was very lucky a few weeks ago. And I noticed in here that somebody had been in and actually cut an awful lot of the grass back. And it was the guy who owns the bit of land just at the top. You won't be able to see, but just sort of kind of above the low scrubs here. It's where he's bought that bit of land and got his fruit trees on there. I think because I sort of maintain pathways, the only way he can get to his land at the moment is through mine. So I kind of maintain the pathways for him to get through. It was kind of a thank you for doing that. So he's done a massive area in there, which was all like this at the front here, you know, just really long grass and weeds there. So that has made this job an awful lot easier. But still, you see, it's overgrown. It's got scrubby stuff growing up everywhere. It just needs to sort of get in and sort it a bit at a time. So let me show you now some of the areas that I have already done. So this area over here, which after the rain, I think this one was, I was cut this over a month ago now, maybe 6 weeks ago. And doesn't that look lovely? Just nice fresh green grass coming through. Hardly any scrubby bits. There's that over there, that's an oak, so that will stay. That little scrubby thing there needs to come out. That's a giant ant nest, so that will stay. And then along the edge, I've kind of left just some of the roses. A big thicket down there, that's wild cherries. they do make fruits and they are nice shaped trees, so they're staying. So yeah, it makes a big difference once you've sort of got in and cut it back properly and trimmed it down. So then last week, I've just cut the grass on this section up here. So that's all been cut and raked down into the veggie area. This is a nice plum tree, actually, this one here, although it's dead old. Last year it did have quite a few plums on it and they were really tasty. So I'm hoping next year. I kind of find my fruit trees, the bigger ones, they kind of sort of have a year and then they miss a year with producing fruit. So maybe next year will be its year. But yeah, you can see all these tiny little scrubby things all need to be cut out. Another little oak tree there, so that will stay. And I'll cut out the one behind it to give it a bit of space. So I've just now this morning, I've just been working on this side, which you can see, you know, is mostly grass now, hasn't got, there's one tree going to be left there, and a little thicket of ground elder, again for the berries, but all the rest, all the other little scrubby bits, I've just sort of cut out from here and dragged away, so this is sort of nice and clear, either for replanting different trees or shrubs, or just generally making it easier for when I want to cut the grass and hay next time. That up there, that's being left as a bit of a sort of thicket. It's kind of a little hedge because just behind it is a really nice sort of seating area. It's kind of the highest point and you can see the mountain, so it's sort of nice to have that little bit of privacy. Unfortunately, that big tree, tallest tree there, is a big old pear tree, and that's this year has completely died now, so that will have to come down in autumn. But luckily there's a few self-seeded pears growing up around it. Again, they won't have the fruit on them, but they're a nice shape and they're nice for the shade and for the birds to use. Just here along here, I don't know if you can see, there's like little sticks poking up out the ground which sort of go along there and then curve up. That's where I've got a variety of herbs which went in last autumn and they've survived fine. So there's like chives and there's goldenrod there, some different sorts of thymes, marjoram and so on. So they're just doing their own thing, but nice for the insects. And this hillside has been cleared as well, again just leaving a few sort of trees along the edge of the path at the top there, but clearing the rest of it. So quite pleased with what I've achieved so far. So it's just that one section now that I started off showing you. Yeah, so it's hard work, especially with it being so hot. I just have like a few hours in the morning, you know, sort of starting at about 6:30 when it's still nice and cool before the insects go crazy. But getting there with it, yeah, once you start, it's not so bad. It doesn't take as long as you sort of first think when you're first looking at it. I'll just show you where I've barrowed all the dried grass in as well. So yeah, that's some of it along there. I think that was the second lot that came in there. Stuff that I brought in yesterday has just gone down the bottom here. So like I say, the idea is it will protect the weed matting here, which does get worn away with me walking on it all the time, so it will protect that. I'm hopefully putting it down thickly enough that even when the seeds, not showing you very well there because of the sun right on the lens, show it this way better. Yeah, hopefully putting it down thickly enough that even when the seeds drop off of all the weeds that are in there, they won't then be able to germinate because it'll be too far down for them, it'd be too dark. Which worked before when I deliberately bought bales of hay at the other house I was at and put that round the tomatoes. It just worked as a nice mulch, things didn't germinate. If I've got a forest of weeds in here next summer, then there'll be another video and I'll be warning everybody, don't do it, don't harvest your own hay. But yeah, that's the plan so far.